morning, everybody. I am Dr. Anupama Deshpande. Our today's topic is Enlightening Basics of PhD Qualification. By and large, PhD qualification is nothing but a research. The purpose of research is to discover answers to questions through the application of scientific procedures. The main aim of research is to find out the truth which is hidden and which has not been discovered as yet. Research is a movement from the known to the unknown. We all possess the vital instinct of inquisitiveness for the unknown confronting us, which makes us probe and attain full and fuller understanding of the unknown. This inquisitiveness is the mother of all knowledge, and the method which man employs for obtaining the knowledge of whatever is the unknown can be termed as research. In Master of Philosophy, the researcher has full freedom to choose his her topic of interest. The student is supposed to study in detail the topic relevant to their course contents only and prove it experimentally in science subjects. Though the research at Master of Philosophy does demand authoritativeness, in general, it does not contribute to the original knowledge that is novel and unique. It only takes a forward step in a particular branch of human knowledge. However, the objectives of a master's dissertation does provide a range of learning opportunities to go for original research work in future and equips the learner with the knowledge of managing a project for PhD work. One more fundamental difference between these two reports, that is MPhil and PhD, is that a PhD report's evaluation is either 100% or null. But for MPhil report, it can be, say, 75% or 80%, that is acceptable with a little deficiency also. Decision-making capacity is essential in managing the research, as it requires selection of the best alternative from the available set of alternatives. These decisions should be based upon appropriate studies, evaluations, and observations so as to enable one to develop the knowledge and skills needed to solve the problems and to meet the challenges of the society, environment, innovations, etc. Thus, today's effort is to clear your dilemma about how to proceed for PhD qualification with a clear concept of its requirements. It is essential that PhD research enlightens your reader right from motivation of your study, general background of the chosen topic, filling of gaps in literature survey of the topic, theory utilized in the topic, methodology used, data collection process to its result analysis, conclusion, and future scope. Then we come to what is research. It is clear that research is a process for collecting, analyzing, interpreting information to answer questions. But to qualify as research, the process must have certain characteristics. It must be controlled, rigorous, systematic, valid and verifiable, empirical and critical. In short, your research must establish a specific contribution to the advancement of creativity, insights, knowledge, and understanding in a particular area. In scientific subjects, exploring the relationship between two variables care is taken to link the cause and effect relationship perfectly and to minimize the effect of other factors affecting their relationship. However, in social sciences, it is extremely difficult as research is carried out on issues related to human beings living in society where such controls are impossible. Therefore, in the social sciences, as you cannot control external factors, you attempt to quantify their impact. One must ensure that any conclusions drawn by you are based upon hard evidence gathered from information collected from real life experiences or observations of the experiment. Hence, valid and verifiable not only by you but also by others. Critical scrutiny of procedures used and the methods employed is crucial to a research inquiry. The process of investigation must be foolproof and free from any drawbacks. The process adopted and the procedures used must be able to withstand critical scrutiny by others also. Thus, for a process to be called research, it is imperative that it has the above characteristics. However, it is also necessary to ensure that your work is ethical, and if others' material is used whenever necessary, it is done with their prior permission only. Fabrication, falsification, omitting data, and plagiarism constitute misconduct and academic fraud in any research practice. So the researcher should avoid it right from proposal to final report of his research. Research process is a creative process. It is circular and leads to more questions. Research process always includes analysis and synthesis part. It is searching for explanation of events, phenomena, relationships, and causes. Research is considered as a scientific method of solving a problem. A PhD research starts with establishing what you wish to achieve and what particular issues you wish to address through such research. Application-oriented research process. It is obvious that research is a process and it has to have certain orientation, objective, and planning to achieve the results. Scientific research is a structured inquiry that utilizes acceptable scientific methodology to solve problems and create new knowledge that is generally applicable. Scientific methods consist of systematic observation, classification, and interpretation of data. All well-designed, conducted research has potential application. A research endeavor from the perspective of its application can be divided into two categories: fundamental or pure research and applied research. Pure basic research involves developing and testing theories and hypotheses that are intellectually challenging to the researcher but may or may not have practical application at the present time or in the future also. It is nothing but discovery of new knowledge but theoretical in nature. Thus, pure research forms the body of research methodology. Examples of pure research include developing a sampling technique that can be applied to a particular situation, developing a methodology to assess the validity of a procedure, developing an instrument say to measure the stress level in people, finding the best way of measuring people's attitudes. A simple comparison between fundamental and applied research can be shown as research studies carried on with a view to make generalizations about human behavior are also examples of fundamental research. But research aimed at certain conclusions, say a solution facing a concrete social or business problem, is an example of applied research. The central aim of applied research is to discover a solution for some pressing practical problem, whereas basic research is directed towards finding information that has a broad base of applications and thus adds to the already existing organized body of scientific knowledge. Formulating research topic. No journey can start without knowing where you want to reach and how. Similarly, a PhD thesis cannot start without establishing what you wish to achieve and what particular issues you wish to address through such research. The obstacles which hinder our path are regarded as problem. Problem is the obstacle in the path of satisfying our needs, said by John Jeffrey. Problem is a question to be solved, John G. Tonstein. That is, we have to be able to pose a question to our requirements to be filled. Further slides indicate how to ensure quality in your thesis by giving special attention to which salient features. Similarly, a PhD thesis cannot start without establishing what you wish to achieve and what particular issues you wish to address through such research. The question you want to answer must be original. Don't repeat what others have said before. Your topic, along with being interesting and original, must be significant to the area of knowledge. It must have an impact on the way the society or industry functions. Your topic must encourage others to take up similar research, considering other dimensions of the issue. If this is not the case, your work is less likely to be cited by other scholars. Thus, we give the topic's basic requirements. Then comes planning of research. It is desirable to study at least 4 topics interrelated to your research topic through worldwide literature survey. The thorough study of such 4 topics will enable you to plan a novel problem having a global impact, beneficial to society and academicians. Literature survey should also enable you to plan the tentative methodology for solving your problem. Then comes research methods. Another task is to understand the various research methods and choose the one suitable for your aim, that is your new problem, so that your research can lead to new and acceptable contribution. Research methods correspond to specific techniques, tools or procedures applied to achieve a given objective. Research methods in economics include regression analysis, mathematical analysis, operational research, surveys and data gathering, etc. Methodology is a general approach to inquiry in a given field. It includes analysis of principles of methods, rules in the discipline. It's a systematic study of methods involved in some field for problem solving. Research methodology consists of various research techniques, research procedures, research methods, which can be applied for collecting information on which you intend to do research. That is, it can be a situation, an issue, a problem, a phenomenon, so as to utilize the generated information or gathered information for policy formulation, administration, enhancement of understanding of a phenomenon. This is how we come down to the necessity of learning various research methodologies suitable for one's own research. Then comes scientific methods. Scientific methods are systematic, controlled, and well ordered. They allow replication, explanation rather than description of the phenomena, answer to why. It answers questions like what things occur, why things occur, how things occur, and what are their interactions. Research is a process planned and managed to make the information gathered credible. Scientific methods do not allow description of the phenomena but demand answer to why. These methods are required in engineering also, so that a new discovery strategy is generated. One can also find a better method for the existing research as is a research problem, but one must be able to prove its value beyond any doubt. Hereafter, it will be emphasized how literature survey and literature review form the backbone steps to get started for PhD qualification. Once your synopsis gets ready for approval, then you can proceed for actual research for solving your problem. Problem designing, gap analysis. Once you get a tentative idea about your field of interest, the most important part of research is literature survey. Thorough literature survey only can enable the scholar to fix his research problem concretely and precisely, guide you the significant topics in book. Synthesis. Combine ideas from literature survey relevant to your interest in order to form an integrated theory or system through critical evaluation, compare, contrast, etc. Evaluation. Assess the research in literature survey based on criteria you choose. State and explain to support your evaluation of literature survey with research. Gaps finding. Start writing the gaps observed in the literature related to your problem interest. A meaningful study of relevant literature and its assessment can lead you to finalize your topic. The success of your problem designing totally depends on your quality literature survey. Now one has to face the question of how to study a particular literature or what is meant by a meaningful study. Literature survey pattern. Let us know various approaches to study a particular paper and note down the matter of interest from each paper related to one's field of interest or one's problem. This is very necessary to pinpoint your research problem. The pattern to be followed for studying each paper is: summary, briefly state the argument and main points of relevant research in the chosen paper. Analysis, closely examine the elements or structure of the research in each paper and interpret through the lens of your chosen field. Table, make a table of salient features of the chosen literature. It is necessary to make very wise notes while reading each paper, as that can be later included in your thesis under the chapter of literature survey. literature review critical. You are expected to give review of minimum 8 to 10 papers directly related to your problem statement and cover the general review from remaining connected papers. This is required for your synopsis for finalizing your objectives of PhD research. Simultaneously, note down the methods used in various papers leading to results so that you can choose a right method for your problem, avoid any repetition, or introduce improvisation in the chosen method. For this part of research, one has to find the most suitable references, including journals, books, online sources, etc. You have to review the references for confirming reliability and relevance of your topic. One has to make a table for critical review about each literature findings, methodology, conclusion, and gaps observed. Review each reference with a critical angle to support your research work. An elaborate method is suggested to study the references to create reliability and relevance for your objectives. Initially, make a table for literature survey showing serial number, year of publication, title, author, abstract, motivation and objectives, methodology used, results, discussion and conclusion, gaps relevant to fix your problem statement. You can write 4-5 sentences related to the above points for each paper and utilize the general and critical review remarks for the entire literature for your problem statement finalization as well as thesis writing. Follow references from one paper to another until you start knowing the area extremely well. Then literature survey of last 30 years papers will enable you to finalize your research problem and prepare your synopsis. More specifically, the literature review of last 1 year's conference proceedings, say IEEE, is valid for choosing the topic in vogue. Topic and PhD research proposal. Now comes the critical part of your PhD program, that is to finalize your research topic. Identifying PhD problem can actually be the hardest part of your research. The guide should be able to help you in thought clearing, development and research design for achieving PhD qualification. An effort is made to guide you with relevant questions so that your thought process enables you to confidently finalize your research topic and problem statement based on literature survey and literature review respectively. Field of research can be your specialization or develop mastery in the area of interest. The topic must be suggestive of your intentions through the research and appealing to the academic fraternity. In general, your topic should be unique, meaningful, and encouraging further research. What do we do in literature review? We find the current trends in our subject of interest through literature survey and its review. Literature survey and literature review are an integral part of the entire research process. Questions to review literature survey, slide number 1. A further guidance is given to ask certain questions to yourself to make your literature review worthwhile. Who has done what and how? What are the origins and definitions of the topic? Are motivation and invention the same or what is the difference? What are the key sources, major issues and debates? Is there any cognition involved? different arguments about the topic. A close study of authors' views is a must. Critical review of literature enables one to locate the gaps open for one's research. The questions raised guide you to notify the salient points relevant to your problem so that it ultimately leads you to finalize your problem statement with desirable uniqueness. Then comes questions elaborated. Further, very relevant questions are posed to enable you to enrich your synopsis and lead to significantly useful problem statement. What are the key theories, concepts, and ideas dealt with? What are the main questions, problems that have been addressed to data? That is, what are the findings? What is their plan for further work? Have they reported more decent work in a conference? What opportunities are available for confirming the results of others and expanding their results and conclusions? Further questions. Who has done what, how, and what is not perfect? Is there any gap in the literature review? What are their samples? What have they done? In what different ways can you see the problem? Additional questions are given to guide you about some more points that need to be noted from each paper, thus leading you to critically read each paper, apply your mind, thoughts, and senses to gather the essence and lead to a notable research problem. You can even expand and confirm someone's results further with a more effective methodology as your research problem. What topic can you choose to work on? Try a paper in some topic and find out any recent publication in the same topic. Answers to such questions lead to your problem statement. It is worth mentioning here the possible sources for literature search, so that you are damn sure about your survey and can confidently work on your problem to make it definitely innovative. Archives, computers, short journal articles, leading IEEE journals, apart from ISBN, ISSN journal articles, books, conference papers, patents, thesis, keyword searching on internet, trade magazines, etc. Outcomes of literature survey. Reiterating the significance of literature survey and its review to rethink and reformulate your research problem so as to ensure definite methodology and definite experimentation to ascertain the solution of the problem, thus trying to virtually enlighten the entire process of PhD. Literature survey is time consuming, daunting, frustrating, but rewarding. Its functions are: bring clarity and focus to your research problem, improve your methodology, broaden your knowledge or expertise in your field of interest, contextualize your findings, helps to analyze your findings. Thus, literature survey can improvise your research problem. Development of problem statement. Next is the development of your problem statement, taking into account all the aspects of your research plan. This statement is a part of the introduction of your thesis. Answering the 5 W's enable you to polish your problem statement with right approach and right words. A smart idea for formulating a problem statement is to try to answer the 5 W's: who, what, where, when, and why, plus how. Addressing the 5 W's gives your reader a good baseline level of knowledge to understand the problem and solution without treading into unnecessarily levels of details. Also, check your problem statement for questions like, does it seem to flow properly? Does it present its ideas coherently? Does it seem to be logically organized? Problem statement polishing. Thorough revision and editing of the problem statement is a must. The problem statement should be free from any loopholes in terms of facts and figures, language or format. All frivolous details must be removed and essential facts must be highlighted. Your problem statement will ensure that the readers be interested in going through your entire report. Summarizing all the requirements of problem statement, it is necessary to view your final statement through the lens of all these requirements again and again to land in best problem statement. A good rule of thumb is to only address problems that you can definitively solve beyond the shadow of a doubt. It is necessary to write only what you know about or can authentically explain about, which can make the thesis shorter, faster, and easier to write and of higher quality. Better not to try to include every data about the problem, whether you understood it or not. It should be as informative as possible, in as few words as possible, but should not delve into minute details. At the same time, it should be crisp and rather attractive. Objectives of synopsis. Synopsis is nothing but your research proposal for PhD confirmation, and it must comprise the given points. The first step is to explain what you have chosen to study and, more importantly, why. Explain the ideal situation and point out the deficits or impediments to such conditions that you wish to address through your research. The rationale for study needs to be clearly communicated to justify an in-depth research. The particular issues which you wish to address and achieve through your research should be enumerated. The research intentions must be very clear and appealing to the academic fraternity. Your proposal should elaborate the meaning of your problem statement and bring clarity about what are you going to do. That too with proper justification for confirming an in-depth research in that topic. The objective should be crystal clear to you to the extent of being able to convince the committee that it is because of your research efforts the situation of the issue will be improved, otherwise would have been worsened. Justify your explanation with desirable ideal conditions that can be achieved just because of your research efforts. You must elaborate the methodology to collect authentic, reliable, factual data to back up your objectives and the expected solution. Hypothesis. Hypothesis is nothing but an explanation of theory which can be provisionally accepted to interpret certain phenomena and to provide guidance for further investigation. Depending upon your research question, you can have one or more hypotheses. There is a difference between hypothesis and prediction. There can be several predictions on one hypothesis. We can have predictions on why it would be worse. It should be possible to test the comments given from the data collected to verify the hypothesis. Hypothesis is nothing but understanding the problem so as to guess your prediction about its solution. If our guess comes correct, then we can mention in the conclusion that our hypothesis is verified by the facts in the observations. It can go wrong also. Writing some hypothesis serves to indicate your depth of understanding of your research problem and thereby to predict some judgment about the solution of your problem, which can be later verified for its correctness through some tests. Basic structure of hypothesis. The basic structure of hypothesis contains independent variables and dependent variables. Hypothesis is nothing but an expected relationship between its independent and dependent variables used in defining the research problem. The slide clearly elaborates the concept of hypothesis. Independent variables are the ones controlled by the researcher for any change to cause a certain effect. Dependent variables are the ones which can be measured or observed to show the effect of change in independent variables. Literature survey can lead to hypothesis, or researcher might draw a hypothesis from a specific theory or build on previous research to get an alternative hypothesis. Hypothesis statement. A very simple guidance is given to formulate the hypothesis statement. Reading questions for hypothesis formulation are: what the problem is, what I think will happen, why I think it will happen. Proceed for the first question with if and explain what your problem is. Proceed for the second question with your hypothetical answer, starting with then, and explain what your prediction is using the variables used in your problem statement. Proceed for the third question with because, as you have to reply to why do you think so. Let us understand one example to illustrate the application of each question. Question 1 is starting with if I drop a basketball from 1 meter above the ground. Question 2, starting with then I think that it will bounce back maximum if the ground is of concrete. Concrete was one of the options in my problem statement, and I have chosen that for answering the question what I think will happen in formulating my hypothesis. Question 3, starting with because, to reply for why question, because concrete is the most dense material. Let us see another example. If I feed my plant energy drink, then it will grow faster. Or if fertilizer is given to plant, then the plants will grow taller. That is, energy drink or fertilizer are independent variables, and grow faster or taller are dependent variables. In testing, I am doing some experiment and testing my prediction, and depending upon my results, I am either confirming or denying my hypothesis. Thus, hypothesis is a testable prediction either by experiment or by statistical tests. Hence, hypothesis should be logical, accounting for relevant information, testable and simple. Collecting data and experiment designing. Choice of questionnaire or experiment designing depends on the field of your research, whether arts or science subject. Questionnaire is a preferred method for arts field. For research methods, one has to choose the most appropriate research method along with a comparison with other methods such as qualitative and quantitative methods. The questionnaire is expected to contain 10% questions of the total population for data collection. More the questions, more or objective type questions, expecting answer in yes or no. An experiment is a tool that you design to find out if your ideas about your topic are right or wrong. Your research proposal must talk about data collection methods, sample size, data analysis methods, and tools used. Once you collect the data, its analysis is imperative. Questionnaire and experiment. Further guidance is given for selecting the research methodology and design of questionnaire, as the success of research depends upon the quality of data collected. The success of any research largely rests on the data and the understanding of such data. While questionnaires will help you to collect data, experiments lead to outcomes based on certain variables and assumptions. You may adopt different methods for collection of information, and questionnaire is one of the most frequently used tools. Analysis is a summary of the experiment's results and how those results match up to your hypothesis. How to formulate questionnaire? A guideline is given even to design a questionnaire to make it interesting and not boring for the participants, so that the population's interest is maintained in answering the questions till the last question. Keep it short and simple. Keep the questions must be crisp and precise so that respondents can understand them easily. Remember to keep the most thought-provoking questions towards the end. Only the respondents who are genuinely interested in your study will stay till the end and provide valuable suggestions. The beginning should include general questions aimed at stimulating interest in the respondents. Additional question suggestions. It is necessary to know what should be avoided in formulating the questionnaire. Challenging questions right in the beginning might ward off the respondents. You must choose between open-ended and closed-ended questions as per the nature of your study. While closed-ended questions are easy to answer as well as evaluate, they certainly lack originality. In a study where perceptions or beliefs of respondents are to be analyzed, open-ended questions suit best. Experiments. Similar guidelines and precautions are given for conducting experiments for science subjects. Experiment, of course, requires more preparation, more precautions while conducting and noting the results. An experiment typically tests hypothesis or validates a certain theory by using a set of variables and assumptions. Experimental material should be well in place before conducting the experiment, and the researcher must be fully equipped to take readings, notes, and record reactions. If you miss out a single step of an experiment or fail to note the reactions that you see, your project can go haywire. Expectation from a PhD student. The thesis should be a scholarly document making an original contribution to offer stimulating ideas. That is, one must constantly reread and revise what one has just written to get as close to the right expression as one could in the first time round itself. Display good grasp of the subject. Many students carry a wrong notion that thesis should be long. On the contrary, what is more important is to maintain the flow of thesis, sticking to your research problem so that the reader is constantly reminded of the problem and its solution. One must write what one has understood to get the right clarity of expression without any ambiguity. Analysis and interpretation of data should be proper and valid, duly supported by charts, tables, diagrams, etc. Appropriate statistical tools, measures should be used. One must use proper software for drawing figures to make the figures perfect and clear. Your results should be sufficient to satisfy the purpose of your research to the reader. Your discussion of results should relate to the objectives of study to imply successful completion of the project. Conclusions drawn should be sound and balanced. Your conclusions must highlight the need of your research and emphasize the practical applications of the proposed solution. It virtually forms the basis of your defense. Thanks.